Hello dear students, I am Dr. Sanjay Pagar, Associate Professor, Department of Geography. Dear student, I welcome all of you in this online video lecture series on behalf of Maratha Vidya Prasar Samajas, Karate Arts, Veg Commerce and AM Science, popularly known as KTHM College, Nashik. Dear student, this is our MA-MSc Geography Part 1st Class, Semester 1 and today we are going to discuss our paper. The title of our paper is Principle of Economic Geography and paper code of this subject is GGUT113. Dear student, today we are going to start our new topic, that is topic number 5, Transport and the Communication. And in this topic, we have a subtopic, that is definition of transport and communication. Dear student, in the previous lecture, we have discussed detailed information about Mardal's model. Today, we are going to discuss a very simple subtopic, that is to discuss the definition and the transport of the communication. Dear student, a country cannot develop so fast without develop transport and the communication system. So, it is a basic needs of the transport and communication system is a basic need of the economic development of that country. So, without transport and communication, we are not carried out the economic development of that country. The modern transport and the communication facilities play an important role for integrated economic development. It play a major role in economic uplift of a country. Uplift means to develop the country. So, to development of the economy of that country, so for the various purpose, we are using transport and communication facilities. So, therefore, it is a very important with respect to the economic development of the country. Transport is important because it enables communication, trade and other form of exchange between people. So, for that purpose, the transport is very important. If we are talking about the communication is very necessary for human existence. It is a medium of sending and receiving information through various means of communication. So, this is also very important. So, communication is very vital aspect of the society in which without it will be difficult for spatial interaction to take place. So, dear student, we discuss about the importance of the transport and communication. Now, let us discuss the definition of both terms. Transport and communication. First, let us discuss the meaning and the definition of transport. Dear student, you know that transport is an activity of taking goods or the people from one place to another place in a vehicle. That is very important. In transportation, what is main purpose? The main purpose of transportation is taking goods or the people from one place to another place in vehicle. That is very important. So, transportation is activity of taking goods or people from one place to another place in the vehicle. Dear student, so for that purpose, we are using the various types of vehicles. It may be the bus, it may be the truck, it may be the railway, airplane, helicopter, sea, boat, whatever it is we are using for the purpose. And through this, using this vehicle, we are taking the goods and place from one geographical region to another geographical region. Let us discuss the second important definition. Transport or the transportation is the movement of the human being, animal and goods from one location to another location. See, in this definition, one new word is added, that is animals. So, in first definition, we are just talking about the goods and people, means human being. But in second definition, the transport or the transportation is the movement of the human being, means people. The animals also added and the goods from one geographical location to another location. So, means in simple way, we can say that the transport is nothing but is a movement of the people or the human beings, animals and the goods from one place to another place. Dear student, the most common modes of transportation that we are using, that is railway, roadway, airway, waterway and pipeline. And by using these modes of transportation, we continue the economic development and the various important work in the country. And you know that again I am talking about the transport is a main base for the economic development process of the country. Let us talk about the what is communication. So communication is the process of the conveying messages to other, from one person to the another person. That is simple. The communication is transfer of information from one person to another person. So that is very important. So in communication process, what we are doing? We transfer the information. Information in the form of message or in form of any idea, we convey or you transfer that idea, that message from one person to the another person, that we are seeing in this definition. Third important definition of the communication is the exchanging of information by speaking, writing, or using some other medium is known as a communication. See, in this definition, what is important? The exchanging of the information. It may be by speaking directly face to face, we can speak, writing with help of the paper and pen, we can write our message and convey this message, pass this message from one person to another person, and using the some other medium. It may be the like a telephone, like a mobile, like a email, or maybe so by using the various means of communication, we can pass our message or idea from one person to another person. So in this definition, these three things are very important, that exchanging of the information by speaking, writing, or the using the some other media is known as the communication. So one important definition that I would like to share with you, that is the definition is given by Fred G. Meyer. According to him, communication is the intercourse by words, letter, or the message. See, in this definition, he used a similar word, that is the intercourse. Intercourse means similar, like a exchange. So in this, communication is a process in which it is a intercourse by words, letter, and message. So through this process, we can also able to convey our message, our idea, or what we'd like to communicate with the other person, that we can do through the words, letters, and messages through the intercourse process. So in this definition, these things are very important. I read again that what is the communication according to Meyer. The communication is the intercourse by words, letter, or the message. So this was about the definition that given by the Meyer. In simple word, it is a process of transmitting and the sharing idea, opinions, facts, value from one person to another person, or maybe from one organization to another. See, it doesn't mean that this communication process only happen in the person, but it can be happen organization to another organization. It may be the government board, the government of one state can communicate with another state. The one industry can communicate with the another industry. So one group of the institute can communicate with the another group of the institute. So therefore, in this simple word, you can say that it is a process, that communication is the process of transmitting and the sharing the ideas, opinions, the facts, value, extra from one person to another person. So that everything, this all thing we are doing every day. So in the school, in the college, in the university, in the office, in the railway station, in the market, everywhere we are doing same thing. We are transforming and sharing our idea, our opinion, our facts, our various value from one person to another person. So that we are expected in the communication process. Dear student, so you know that the second subtopic of this chapter is the various modes of transportation. So various modes of transportation, that is second subtopic. See student, the meaning of word modes means what? Way, type, or style. So when we are talking about the modes of transportation, first see the what is the meaning of modes. The meaning of the modes means way, type, or the style. And the meaning of transportation means, we just explain that it is nothing but the process of transport person or the goods from one place to another place, or carry from one place to another place. So therefore, for the transportation purpose, we are using the various modes that are very important source of the transportation. For transportation, mainly we are using the roadway, railway, airway, waterway, and the pipeline. These are the major modes of transportation that human being use since a long period, and even the more modern period, the use of this transportation, modes of transportation, increased day by day. So it is very important for economic development of the country, That is very important. Especially, I am talking about the roadway and railway constitute the main form of transport on the land. The maximum, the transportation, for the transportation purpose, we use the these two modes of transportation, that is the roadway and the railway. The both things are very important as a this is a very important requirement of the human being, and we are using on a large scale on the surface. The waterway, ocean going ships, boat are used mainly. It is a mainly run in the ocean, lake, river, or the canal from one place to another place. Dear students, see, since a long period, we are using the waterway for the international trade purpose, and that was the main source of the trade of the international community. So, and see, so it is a, as compared to other modes of transport, it's a very cheap modes of transportation. And one thing is important, that there is not too much the difficulty when we carried out the the transportation through the waterway. That time we are not facing too much problem as compared to other modes of transportation. Therefore, this is a very important modes of transportation. The aeroplanes, the helicopter, and the cable trolley are also the principal type of air transportation that we are using for the international trade purpose, or maybe the we can also carry the passenger from one nation to the other nation if you want to do the long travel, long journey. So that in that purpose, the air transport is a very important modes of transportation. Then sometime the pipeline also used for the transport of the oil and waterway purpose. So especially I'm talking about the America and the, some most of the European country, they are using the pipeline for the transport of the oil and the natural gas and the water purpose also. That is very important. Even recently, the use of the pipeline also is increasing on a large scale, especially in the metropolitan city of the India. So therefore, this is a very important modes of transportation. So use of modes of modes and the means of transportation depend on the nature of commodities and the distance between place where we have to carry this commodity. See, this last sentence is very important, because see, if you want to select the proper mode of modes of transportation for the transportation purpose, so that totally depend on the what type of the nature of the commodities that we are carry from one place to another. Whether it is a perishable things like a vegetable and the milk items, or maybe it is a bulky things like a coal, iron ore, and iron ore, and maybe the other. Maybe it is a light commodity, or like it is a valuable commodity, like it is a breakable commodity. Commodities. So commodities very important. So depend on that. So what type of the nature of the commodity, that depend on that commodity, we are using the proper modes of transport. Suppose you want to carry out the very valuable and the light commodity, then for that purpose the air transport is always good. Suppose you want to carry out the bulky commodity, then for that purpose the maybe the waterway, ship and boat, or maybe the railway is a very good option. If you want to the very perishable thing, then maybe the fast modes of transportation that can cover the distance between the two close location, that maybe the for that purpose the truck is very important, truck or maybe the jeep or maybe the tempo is very important modes of transportation. So therefore, dear student, so and another thing is the distance between two places is very important. If you want to carry out the anything but the goods from one place to a long distance, maybe between two nations, so for that purpose definitely that air transport is very important. But again, if that the commodity is very bulky, then for that purpose for a long distance we can use the waterway also. So this is a very important thing, and for various purpose we are using the various modes of transportation that totally depend on the what type of the nature of the commodities, or maybe the what type of the how much distance that are available between two places, and where we want to carry the goods and maybe the people. So that depend on the that distance of the between the places. So dear student, this was about the various modes of, this was the just introduction. In the next lecture we are going to discuss all modes of transportation one by one. What are the advantages, what are the disadvantages, what is the use of the each and every modes of transportation, that we are going to discuss in our next lecture. So okay, thank you.